We are in a chapter called trigonometry. In the previous classes, I told you this is one of the very wonderful chapter in mathematics. Trigonometry, we are learning trigonometry from the basics. Therefore, you have to give utmost interest to this particular lesson because this lesson you are going to carry to your higher studies. Trigonometry, what all I told in the previous classes, trigonometry is a Greek word. Trigonometry means triangle measurement or three angle measurement. Trigonometry was widely used in astronomy. At present, trigonometry is used to calculate heights and distances. Trigonometry is confined to right angled triangle. Right angled triangle is a triangle in which one angle is equal to 90 degree, other two angles are complementary angles. And they are acute angles. And we are going to identify, name them by theta. And the value of theta is greater than or equal to 0 or less than or equal to 90. With respect to theta, the sides of the right angle triangle are named as opposite side, adjacent side and hypotenuse. Using these sides, we can define 6 trigonometrical ratios. How many? 6. They are sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosecant theta, secant theta and cot theta. And you know that those ratios, sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Every time you have to repeat. Because once you learn in this particular ratios in 10th standard, you are going to continue that. You can't forget this. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. Tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. Cosecant theta is equal to hypotenuse by opposite. Secant theta is equal to hypotenuse by adjacent. And cot theta is equal to adjacent by opposite. That you have to remember. Based on these 6 trigonometrical ratios, we have one exercise. That is exercise 11.1. In that exercise, I completed 8 problems, right? 8 problems are completed. I told you, you make a separate book. Write the definition notes and the ratios, everything. Then solve the exercise, problems in the exercise. By that, how much marks we are going to get? 7 marks. Therefore, give your attention and practice all the problems independently. While I solve, you also solve. Then after that, you have to practice it. Right? Now see here. 9th problem. See this problem, we solve this problem in the classroom. Some of them came and they did this problem on the board. Simple problem it is. See, 9th problem of exercise 11.1. I made you to solve this problem. Some of the children, they came and solved the problem on the board. See, in triangle ABC, right angled at B, there is a triangle ABC, it is right angled at B. If tan A is equal to 1 by root 3, find the values of, he is given 2 values. You have to find the value of sin A into cos C plus cos A into sin C. The second one is cos A into cos C minus sin A into sin C. What do you have to do? The first thing is, see, I start solving from here only because I require board. Now see, here there is a triangle. What is the name of the triangle? ABC. It is right angled at B, therefore this is B. And tan A is given, I make this as A. This is C. Because by marking acute angle in the base, it is easy to identify. That's all. You can make this also A, no problem. Now ABC is a right angled triangle, right angled at B. Now tan A. He is given tan A. Tan A is equal to 1 by root 3. Tan A is equal to 1 by root 3. It is given in the problem. It is given in the problem. We all know that what is tan? Tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. Opposite by adjacent is equal to 1 by root 3. Therefore, you substitute these values to the triangle. Opposite side to angle A, opposite to side to angle A is BC, that is equal to 1. Adjacent side to A is AB, that is root 3.
I substituted the given values to the diagram. Once I substituted, when I see the triangle, I can easily understand in the triangle there are three sides. Two sides I know at present, one more side I don't know. Therefore, to find that side, I am applying Pythagoras theorem. All problems of exercise 11.1, we use Pythagoras theorem, right? How to apply that? In triangle, what is the name of the triangle? ABC. Which angle is 90? Angle B is equal to 90. Once you write angle B is equal to 90, or any angle is equal to 90, you can easily identify the hypotenuse. Which theorem? Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem. Which is the hypotenuse in this triangle? Angle B is equal to 90, therefore hypotenuse is AC. You have to state the statement of the Pythagoras theorem. In a right angle triangle, square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. AB square plus BC square. Square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. AC square, I don't know the value of AC square. AC square is equal to AB square is root 3 whole square. And BC square is equal to 1 square. AC square is equal to root 3 whole square is 3. Root 3 into root 3. Root 3 into root 3 is 3. Plus 1 square is 1. AC square is equal to 3 plus 1 is 4. AC square is equal to 4 means AC is equal to plus or minus 4. Don't write plus or minus. Square root of 4 is 2 because minus cannot be a side of a triangle. Therefore, hypotenuse is equal to 4. Now all the three sides I know. Now I can find the, I can write any ratio of the trigonometry based for angle A and for angle C. See, first value, first one, what he wants is value of sin A, sin theta with respect to angle A into cos C, cos theta with respect to angle C plus cos A, cos theta with respect to angle A, sin C, sin theta with respect to C. That value he wants. Now, you have to see the diagram. See, with respect to A, sin theta, with respect to A, sin theta means what? Opposite by hypotenuse. Which is the opposite side to angle A? 1. And which is the hypotenuse? 2. Therefore, sin A is equal to half. Cos C, with respect to C, C is here, with respect to C, cos theta. Cos theta means what? Adjacent by hypotenuse. With respect to C, adjacent is BC. Therefore, it is 1 by 2. 1 by 2. Plus, with respect to A, cos theta. With respect to A, cos theta. Cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse. Root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. Into sin C with respect to C, sin theta. Sin theta means opposite by hypotenuse. Root 3 by 2. Right? Now simplification. Very simple. Once you are able to identify the ratios, next is simplification. 1 into 1 is 1, 2 into 2 is 4. Plus root 3 into root 3, 3. 3 into root 3 is 3. 2 into 2 is 4. Now it becomes what? Same denominator. Therefore, numerator as add as it is 4 by 4, which is equal to 1. Therefore, value for the first, value of the first information what he asked is sin A into cos C plus cos A into sin C is 1. That is the first. The second one is, see, I write it here only, value of he wants the value of cos A, cos A, cos C, cos A, cos C minus sin A into sin C. This one you have to see the diagram, right? Cos A, cos C. You see that? Cos A means with respect to A, cos theta. Cos theta means what? Adjacent by hypotenuse. Yes. Root 3 by 2. Cos A is equal to root 3 by 2. Cos C is asking. Cos C is with respect to C, which is adjacent. What? Hypotenuse. Therefore, cos A is equal to root 3 by 2. Cos A is equal to 1 by 2. I write there. Cos A is equal to root 3 by 2. If you write the right angle triangle, and you can easily write cos C is equal to 1 by 2 minus. Now I want sin A, sin C. Sin A and sin C. What is sin theta? Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. Therefore, sin A is equal to 1 by 2. Sin C is equal to root 3 by 2. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. But with respect to A, opposite is 1. With respect to C, opposite is 3, root 3. And hypotenuse is 2. Therefore, sin A. Sin A is equal to 1 by 2. And sin C is equal to root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2. Easy it is. Root 3 into 1 is root 3. 2 into 2 is 4 minus. 1 into root 3 is root 3. 2 into 2 is 4. Root 3 by 4 minus root 3 by 4. Same thing minus same thing is equal to 0. Or you can cancel this like this and write the same. Therefore, the value of cos A, cos C minus sin A, sin C is equal to 0. This problem all of you are solved in the classroom. Therefore, what is your duty now? You have to write and keep and you have to practice. Trigonometry is very easy to score in 10th standard, right? Therefore, practice this. Problem of exercise 11.1. See, the problem is like this. In triangle PQR, there is a triangle PQR, right angle at Q. This right angle PQR is a right angle triangle. The right angle vertex is Q. Then he is given PR plus QR means sum of the two sides is equal to 25. Sum of the two sides is not given a single side. Sum of the two sides is equal to 25. And PQ, one side is equal to 5 cm. Determine the values of sin P, cos P, tan P. This is little bit application. Why? Because we have to apply Pythagoras theorem and find the sides of the right angle triangle. Then we can go for the trigonometry. Therefore, it is a blend of Pythagoras. All problems are based on Pythagoras theorem only, but this is more of a Pythagoras theorem and less of trigonometry is concerned. What is given? First, we analyze the problem. See, here there is a triangle PQR. There is a right angle triangle PQR, right angle dot Q. Then the other sides are PQR. Right? I make it because he wants sin P. I write this as P and this as R. Easy, that's all. This P, Q, R. There is no need. But writing the acute angle at the base, we can easily write it. PQR is a right angle triangle. Here, PQ, PQ value is given, 5. PQ is equal to 5. This measurement is given. And he is given PR plus QR is equal to 25. What is given? PR plus QR is equal to 25. I can write it like this only. I can keep like this only. But instead of keeping like this, what I do is I mark one angle, one side as X cubic, X centimeter. Then I find the other value and then I substitute, right? Let in these two sides this is smaller, right? QR is smaller, therefore I make let QR is equal to X. I make QR is equal to X, then what happens? PR. Therefore, PR plus, in the place of QR, I get X is equal to 25. PR is equal to 25 minus X. This I got to substitute. I consider this QR as X. If I consider QR as X, then PR is equal to 25 minus X. Right? Now, three sides are one side, we know the exact value, one is 5. The other two sides, one is X, another one is 25 minus X. Now, what I do is, I apply Pythagoras theorem and I get the value of X. After knowing the value of X, I can find the value of 25 minus X. Then, three sides prove to be. Then I go for the trigonometry, right? Therefore, before venturing into the trigonometry, first we have to solve this problem using Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, next step is I apply Pythagoras theorem. I think you can able to understand this. PQR is a right angle triangle, right angle at Q. PQ is equal to 5 cm is given. But he is given QR plus PR is equal to 25. I made QR is equal to X. Therefore, PR plus X is equal to 25, PR is equal to 25 minus X. I substituted these values, QR is equal to X and PR is equal to 25 minus X. If I apply Pythagoras theorem, I can find the value of X. Then I substitute and get the values of this, get the values of the sides of the triangle. In triangle, what is the name of the triangle? PQR. Since we are applying Pythagoras theorem, we should have the knowledge of right angle vertex. Q is equal to 90 degrees. Once you know the right angle vertex, you can identify the hypotenuse. Once you know the hypotenuse, you can apply Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem, which is the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse is PR. PR square is equal to QR square plus PQ square. Square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. See children, this is the 10th problem. In 10 times I repeated the statement of the Pythagoras theorem. 11th time. In a right angle triangle, square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. Therefore, you can't forget. If you are concentrating on this video, classroom videos, definitely you are never going to forget the Pythagoras thing, right? PR square is equal to QR square plus PQ square. PR square is 25 minus X whole square. Is equal to QR square is X square. PQ square is 5 square. PQ square is equal to 5 square. Again, the identity, see, these are all identities, you are repeated, you have solved this type of identities from 5th standard. This is A minus B whole square. See, anything, any person, if he is able to see that content for more than 7 times, definitely can register that information permanently in his brain. This is psychological. It is told the previous time, the psychological reinforcement of the content. Repeatedly something is repeated by the brain, it remains in the brain permanently. Now Pythagoras theorem statement, more than 20, 30, 40 times you heard that one, then you have to remember that. Same way, this is an identity, A minus B whole square. A minus B whole square, I think that you have heard this particular identity more than 500 times in your school days. From 5th standard you are hearing this. A minus B whole square. What is A minus B whole square? A square plus B square minus 2AB. If any student is unable to tell this, means from the 5th standard he is not concentrating on his studies. Understand? 500 times if you hear one particular song, you can memorize that song. A minus B, everybody should. What is A minus B whole square? A minus B whole square is equal to A square, means 25 square. 25 is A. Plus B square, X square, minus 2AB, 2 into 25 into x. A square plus b square minus 2ab equals, what is there here? X square plus 5 square is 25. 5 square is 25. 5 into 5, 25. 25 square, 25 into 25, multiply and see, but you have to remember 25 square is 625. Plus x square minus 2 into 25 is 50. X is equal to x square plus 25. See the equation properly, it is an equation. See it properly. Both the sides equation, we have x square. Both the sides we have x square. Therefore, what I can do is, I can cancel x square, both sides same. Then it becomes what? 625, there is no need to write, but again I am writing this. You have to concentrate, you have to concentrate. These are all things you have solved many number of times in school days. 625 minus 15x is equal to 25. Transfer 25 to this side, minus 15 to that side. Then what happens? 625 transfer to this side, minus 25 is equal to minus 50, that side, 50x. Why? What is the purpose of doing like this? Known arithmetical number, algebraic number, classification. 625 minus 25, anybody can tell? 625 minus 25 is 600. 600 is equal to 50x. 600 is equal to 50x. Then what happens to the x? Therefore, x is equal to 600 by 50. 600 by 50. 0, 0, 5 ones are, 5 twelves are. Therefore, x is equal to 12. The value of x is equal to 12. Once the value of x is known to you, you can easily write the values of this. Therefore, QR, QR is equal to x. What is the value of x? 12. QR is equal to 12. PR, what is PR? PR is equal to 25 minus 12. PR is equal to 13. 25 minus 12 is what? 13. Now, I know the values of all the three sides of the triangle. I know the value of QR, I calculated it as 12. And PR is 25 minus 12 is 13. Now I substitute these values to the diagonal. See. Now I understood the value of QR. QR is equal to 12. PR is equal to 13. Therefore, the sides of the triangle PQR are 5, 12 and 13. Once you know this, any trigonometrical ratios you can easily write. Simple it is. What he wants? He wants sin p, cos p, tan p with respect to p. This is p. Now you tell me, you can directly write it because it's the last problem of exercise 11.1. Next problem is true or false. Therefore, sin theta means what? Opposite by hypotenuse. Sin p means opposite is 12, 12 by 13. Sin theta is equal, sin p is equal to 12 by 13. What is cos p? Cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, 5 by 13. What is tan p? Opposite by adjacent, opposite by adjacent, 12 by 5. That much you have to write it. Now see, sin p is equal to, directly I can write because I know this is a many number of times I did. This was sin p is equal to 12 by 13. Sin p is equal to 12 by 13. Cos p, cos theta is equal to adjacent by hypotenuse, that is 5 by 13, and tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent, therefore it is 12 by 5. 12 by 5. See the answer. I repeat once again. See this. This is a problem more of based on Pythagoras theorem. What is given is, PQR is a right angle triangle, right angle at Q. PQ is equal to 5, he is given. But he is given the sum of the two sides. That is, QR plus PR is equal to 25, he is given. PR plus QR is equal to 25. What I did is, I named one side as X, unknown. X is for unknown.
QR is equal to X. Then it becomes what? PR plus QR. QR I made it as X. PR plus X is equal to 25. Therefore, PR is equal to 25 minus X. I substitute. Then we know of the application of Pythagoras theorem. I told you, any student, any person, if he repeats any content, reinforcement, any content for more number of times, it remains in the brain permanently. And the statement of the Pythagoras theorem is repeated so many times in 10th standard, not only in 10th standard, you are studying this from 7th standard. Therefore, any student of 10th standard should be able to state this Pythagoras theorem. If you are unable to state, means that is the evidence that you are not interested in studies. Therefore, what is the statement of the Pythagoras theorem?
In triangle ABC, here in PQR, Q is equal to 90, I apply Pythagoras theorem. Statement of the Pythagoras theorem is, in a right angled triangle, square of the hypotenuse is equal to sum of the squares of the other two sides. Then I substituted, then I able to get the value of X. The value of X, I got it as 12. 12, your X is nothing but QR, therefore QR is equal to 12. One more side I get. Then the other side is 25 minus X. 25 minus X is 30.
Therefore, three sides are 5, 12 and 30. Then I can write the trigonometrical ratios by using those values of the triangle PQR. In trigonometry, we know at present what is the meaning of the word trigonometry. Trigonometry is confined to right angle triangles and six ratios. Which are the six ratios? Sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosecant theta, secant theta and cot theta. And we solve 10 problems, exercise 11.1, all problems are easy problems. In all majority, all problems, we use Pythagoras theorem. And see, it is a practice for both Pythagoras theorem as well as trigonometry, right? Now, we are reached the last part of this particular exercise where he is asking us some of the statements he is given. He is asking us to tell, is it true or false? Simple it is. If you have understood the content nicely, you can easily tell which is true, which is false. And you are asked for justification also. See,
the 11th and the last area of exercise 11.1 is state whether the following are true or false. They are given some of the statements. You have to state that they are true or false and justify your answer. You have to justify, you have to argue, you have to tell, you have to make the other people to understand. That is your work it is. Now I am doing. See here. First statement, read the first statement. The value of tan A is always less than 1. Value of tan A is always less than 1.
If you read the statement, you can easily understand it is always less than 1. First we understand the right angle triangle. See, here there is a right angle triangle. Imagine here there is a right angle triangle. And I will name this as A, B, C. This right angle triangle is right angle at B. In this right angle triangle, with respect to A, this is opposite side, this is adjacent side, and this is hypotenuse. The first thing is you have to remember this. If you are a student of 10th standard, I am not talking about the brilliant students or average student or a low student. Very simple. If you are a student of 10th standard, 15 and 16 years of age, you should be able to understand in the right angle triangle, which is the biggest side? Hypotenuse is the biggest side. Therefore, when you write a tan theta, tan means what? Tan A is equal, tan theta is equal to opposite by adjacent. If it is opposite by adjacent, this value, for example, if I write a side of a right angle triangle, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. Always hypotenuse is the biggest side, that we have to understand. With respect to these two sides, this is 3, now this is 3 by 4. See, if I write the tan theta in this case, it is 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is less than 1. 3 by 4 is less than 1. But imagine, I can make this as 4, this as 3.
When I make this as 4 and this as 3, then this is 4 by 3. 4 by 3 is greater than 1. You can even imagine a right angle triangle where the two sides are equal. These two sides are equal. In such cases, opposite by adjacent cancels and becomes 1. Therefore, tan theta value can be greater than 1, equal to 1, less than 1. It can have any value. Greater than 1, less than 1, or equal to 1. What is his statement? His statement is, the value of tan A is always, sometimes it may be less than 1, but it is not always less than 1. The value of tan theta may be greater than 1, equal to 1, or less than 1. Sometimes it can be less than 1, but not always. Therefore, the first statement is a false statement. This is false. This is a false statement. Impossible. You can't always get tan theta is equal to less than 1. Tan theta can be 3 by 4, 4 by 3, or 4 by 4 in this example. Any other numbers also you can guess, right? Therefore, the first statement is the value of tan A is always less than 1. It is a wrong statement. Therefore, I return as false, right? That is the regarding justification of this particular statement. Second one is asked to tell in that, second statement is secant A. Secant A is equal to 12 by 5. Secant A is equal to 12 by 4 for some value of angle A. Now we come back to this one. See. Okay, I write one more. Right angle triangle. See here. The argumentation. You have to argue. See here. One right angle triangle is there. This is A, this is B, this is C. He is telling that secant A. Secant A means, secant theta means what? Secant theta is equal to hypotenuse by adjacent. Hypotenuse by adjacent. In this case, the secant theta is 12 by 5. 12 by 5 means this is 12, this is 5. 12 by 5. This is 12 by 5. Is it possible to get 12 by 5 for a secant theta for any one example? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible because we know that hypotenuse is the longest side. Therefore, the numerator is bigger, denominator is smaller. Therefore, what the statement, what he is telling is, the value of the secant theta, it may be for some problem, 12 by 5. Not all problem. All problem hypotenuse cannot be 12. Hypotenuse can be anything. But be careful, for all problem hypotenuse should be bigger and the adjacent side should be smaller. In that scenario, this value may be suiting for some problem, right? Therefore, what is asking, the statement is secant A is equal to 12 by 5 for some value of angle A. Yes, for some value of angle A, it is true. But not all values of A, right? Be careful. Always, no. Always secant A is equal to 12 by 5. I can say that it is false. But for some value of angle A, the secant A is equal to 12 by 5 means it is a true statement. It is a, second one is a true statement. It is true. First one is false. Tan A cannot be always less than 1. False. But secant A for some value, it can be 12 by 5. Secant theta should be always greater than 1. Should be greater than 1. Therefore, numerator should be bigger. Denominator should be lesser. Because numerator, in the numerator, we get hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is the longest side of the right angle. Right. And the third one, see. Cos A is the abbreviation used for cosecant of angle A. This is the only thing is the student should be able to read it properly, that's all. Cos A, the full form of cos theta. In every class, every this one, I have given the full chart. If you see the video classes, orientation classes of previous three, or in all the three, I have given a chart. First column, trigonometrical ratios. Second column, complete name. Sin theta, sin theta is equal to sine theta, sine of angle theta. What is cos theta? Cos theta means complement of sin theta. Complement of sin theta is cos theta. But he is telling cosecant. No, it is wrong. It is. It is cos A is not the approbation of cosecant. Cosecant is complement of secant. Cosecant means what? Complement of secant. Cos means complement of sine. Complement of sine is cos. Therefore, this statement is a false statement. Third one is a false statement. Cos A is not the approbation of cosecant theta. Right? And fifth one, these are all very simple. It is cot A is the product of cot and A, meaningless, foolishness. Because cot A itself is a ratio. It is just like if you separate A from cot A, then it is just like a man without head. Can you imagine a man without head? No, impossible. Therefore, cot A is a single unit, it is. It is not the product of cot and A. There is no meaning for the other than the English meaning of cot, forget. There is no meaning in cot and A. It is absolutely wrong. Cot A itself is a ratio. It is not the product of cot and A. It is wrong. False statement. Cot A is cot A. It is not cot and A. It is cot A. The next is, the fifth and the last statement is given is sin theta is equal to 4 by 3. For some angle theta, see the numerator is bigger, denominator is smaller. Is it possible for a case of the sin theta? Sin theta means what? See the diagram. Suppose if I mark this as theta, sin theta is equal to what? Sin theta, this is opposite. This is hypotenuse. Sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse. And we know that hypotenuse is always bigger. Therefore, whenever you write the sin theta, denominator should be bigger. Understood? Because hypotenuse is the longest side of a right angle triangle. Therefore, it should be bigger. He is given what? 4 by 3. It is wrong. Here numerator is bigger, denominator is smaller. This type of value you can't get at all. Sin theta is equal to 4 by 3 is, again, it is a foolishness. Foolishness, no, it is false. It is a false. Therefore, see, the fifth or the last unit of this particular exercise is identifying the statements which are true or false. Why they are given this? First, you have to make it concretize the first unit of trigonometry. The first unit of trigonometry is based on ratios. Again, I repeat, because I have completed exercise 11.1. Now your duty, you are already completed trigonometrical ratios at 11.1. Write in a book. Keep it. And repeatedly solve. Make this information pakka. Then you get definitely marks in the public examination. Now I tell you, once again I repeat. Trigonometry, I told you, how many ratios are there? 6 ratios. First ratio is sin theta, second ratio is cos theta. Sin theta, cos theta, what is the similarity in both the cases, sin theta and cos theta? The value of sin theta and cos theta are always less than 1. Sin theta, cos theta is always less than 1. Because hypotenuse is in the denominator, hypotenuse is the longest, it is less than 1. Same way, the value of cosecant theta and secant theta is always greater than 1. Cosecant theta and secant theta are always greater than 1. Then left with tan theta and cot theta. Value of tan theta and cot theta can be anything. It can be lesser than 1, it can be greater than 1, or it can be equal to 1. That is the idea you have to understand. And have in mind, sin theta, cos theta less than 1. Secant theta, cosecant theta greater than 1. Tan and cot can have any value. That you have to understand, because we are going in the next class, we are going for standard angles. In the standard angles, we have to get the values. Right? Therefore, practice this first exercise, 11.1, and content. Right?